فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
أعمالهم كسراب بقيعة يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا. It's like that mirage. You're trying to get to it, as soon as you get there, there's nothing there. That's what your actions become. Hifd, memorization. You got something in your head. Now the author corrects a belief that many people, or mistake that many people fall into when it comes to the concept of memorization. It's a very common mistake. He's going to now explain that this type of memorization and this type of hifd is incorrect. He says, والمحفوظ المعول عليه. The thing that's memorized, the word mu'awwal means something you go back to. The thing that you memorize and you come back to in memory, huwa matnul jami', it's a comprehensive matn and it's rajih, it has the strongest opinions. How would you know that this book is matnul jami', rajih? He says, أَيِّ الْمُعْتَمَدُ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ الْفَنِّ. The word A in the Arabic language is عَطْفُ بَيَانٍ أَوْ بَدَلٍ. Anything that comes after it can either be عَطْفُ بَيَانٍ or it can be a بَدَلٍ. مَا بَعْدَ A قَاعِدَةٍ. What did the poet say? قَاعِدَةٌ تَشْفِي الْعَلِيلَ مِنَ الس. مَا بَعْدَ A, anything after A is عَطْفُ بَيَانٍ أَوْ بَدَلٍ. So قَاعِدَةٌ, memorize قَاعِدَةٌ, you need to know. Memorize it. So if I wanted to, I can say أَيِّ الْمُعْتَمَدِ. I can say أَلِمْ أَوِّ الْمُعْتَمَدُ. I can say both ways. أَيِّ الْمُعْتَمَدُ عِنْدَ أَهْلِ الْفَنِّ. المُعْتَمَد means that is relied on. عِنْدَ أَهْلِ الْفَنِّ. How do you know that this book is مَتْنُ جَامِعُ رَاجِح? How do you know? The way that you know it is, it is a book, a matin, that the ahl, the people of this field, they rely on this book. It's a book that scholars have taken. It's a matin, al-mu'tamad, it's relied on by the people of the field. They rely on this book. So a person should memorize a book that the scholars of that field don't give importance to. So you want to be, I want to do something new. The author there says, فَلَا يَنْتَفِعُ طَالِبٌ يَحْفَظُ الْمَغْمُورَ فِي فَنٍ. He's not going to benefit the one who memorizes in a field. الْمَغْمُورَ. مَغْمُور means the rare things. He wants to memorize rare books. وَيَتْرُكُ مَشْهُورَهُ. And he leaves off the famous, well-known books. كَمَنْ يَحْفَظُ, like the one who memorizes. أَلْفِيَّةُ الْآثَارِ. He memorized Alfiyat al-Athari in Nahu. وَيَتْرُكُ Alfiyat ibn Malik. And he leaves off Alfiyat ibn Malik. Some people like that. Have you guys ever heard of Alfiyat al-Athari? No. Have you heard of Alfiyat ibn Malik? Majority of students knowledge will say, yes, I heard Alfiyat ibn Malik. It's the book. It's grammar book. It's the big book. On the other hand, like Alfiyat al-Athari is written by Zainuddin Sha'ban ibn Muhammad al-Qurashiyu al-Athariyu, that's his name. The original name of the book is called Kifayatul Ghulam fi I'rab al-Kalam, and it's written in Lamiyah. Lam, Lam, Lam. That's what he finishes with, the book. So now you're going and you're leaving the methodology of the scholars that is well known, which is Alfiyat ibn Malik. It's a kitab which is al-Mu'tamad. عند أهل الفن, according to the people of that field, it is mu'tamad. They rely on this book. This is the book they do. Are you with me, brothers? You turn away from that. You turn away from that book that they rely on. And you go to a book that's no one's heard of. Alfiyat al-Athari. Who are you? Oh, okay, you're memorizing that. He thinks that this is what? قُوَّة مَشَاءَ عَجِيبٌ. I know rare books. But the Shaykh, as he said, فَلَا يَنْتَفِعُ طَالِبٌ, a student will not benefit. يَحْفَظُ الْمَغْمُورَ. Recently, a book called came out when I was in Saudi Arabia, Alfiyat al-Barmawi. It's in what? Alfiyat al-Barmawi is written in Usul al-Fiqh. It's 1,000 lines in Usul al-Fiqh. And I saw students starting to memorize Alfiyat al-Barmawi. And they were leaving off Alfiyatu, the Alfiyah of Maraqi al-Su'ud, لِمُبْتَغِ الرُّقِي وَالسُّعُود. Maraqi al-Su'ud is 1,000 lines in Usul al-Fiqh as well, by Abdullah ibn Hajj al-Shanqiti rahimahullah. They were leaving off a book which is mu'tamad fi ahli hadha al-fan, the people of this particular field of Usul al-Fiqh. This book, Alfiyatu, the Alfiyah of Maraqi al-Su'ud, is a book they know, they've taught it. You have different and many explanations on it, you turn away from that book. And a new book that came out, it's recently published. Al-Barmawi is well known, Shafi'i scholar. He's well known. But the book is rare. Not many people know about it. And the reason why the scholars, they say you memorize a book which is mu'tamad, is because that book is going to have more shuruh, more explanations, more ta'liqat, more faqul ibarat, the words are going to be more open for you. So when you do memorize it, you find more explanation of that book than this rare book that you're talking about. Because this rare book, you're going to memorize it, but not many people have given time to explaining it. So you struggle to find even somebody who's able to read it for you. And that's the second part that's going to come. So the student follows a methodology set by the ulama before. And he follows that silsila and that manhajiyya. And that he doesn't innovate and start a new path, a new trend for himself. Alfiyatul al-Iraqi, for example, and Alfiyatul al-Suyuti, there are two alfiyat in Mustalah al-Hadith. Scholars have praised, like Alfiyatul al-Barmawi, when you look at it, okay, the wordings are easier than Maraqi al-Su'ud, easier. But it's not al-Mu'tamid. If I did want to go, I'll struggle to find many shuruh for it. Iraq, Maraqi al-Su'ud, I find different shuruh. It's taught commonly. I find many sharita, I find many tape for it. And I'll also find many written explanations on it. The same is with Alfiyatul Iraqi and Alfiyatul Suyuti. It's two alfiyat in the field of what? Mustalah al-Hadith. If you look at the scholars, they gave more time to Alfiyatul Iraqi in terms of memorization. They, even when they tell the students, they advise them to memorize Alfiyatul Iraqi, scholars generally. They explain more Alfiyatul Iraqi. Even that the Alfiyatul Suyuti came later and he added extra things onto it that Iraqi didn't mention. Even then, still Al-Mu'tamad. That which is relied on by the ulama is Alfiyatul Iraqi. The reason is because لِأَنَّهُ أَقْعَدْ. He's more grounded in this field. Iraq is more grounded, this is his field. Iraq is the teacher of Hafiz ibn Hajar. So he's more grounded in the field of Mustalah al-Hadith and Suyuti. Second reason is because he attributes each statement إِلَىٰ قَائِلِهِ, to the one who said it. Suyuti doesn't do that much. And last but not least, the Kitab Alfiyatul Iraqi is makhdoom. It's served. It's worked on. It has shuruh. In the sharah called Fathul Mughith by Sakhawi, which is the student of Ibn Hajar, Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi, who explained the book of who? The teacher of Ibn Hajar. It's a powerful book. So a student of knowledge, brothers, he memorizes a matan which is rajih, and the way he and jami', and the way he would know that is it's the mu'tamid inda ahli al-fan. The people of that field, they're the ones who are going to say that this is the book you should memorize. Don't try to explore new things. Don't go out of your way and try to start and see a new book and say, you know, I'm going to memorize this. Because you're going to get tired. You're not going to attain the goal that you're trying to achieve. Now,
one of them. الثاني فأخذه على مفيد ناصح فتفزع إلى شيخ تتفهم عنه معاني يتصف بهذين الوصفين وأولهما الإفادة وهي الأهلية بالعلم فيكون ممن عرف بطلب العلم وتلقيه حتى أدرك فصارت له ملك قوية فيه والأصل في هذا ما أخرجه أبو داود في سننه قال حدثنا زهير بن حرب وعثمان بن أبي شيبة قال حدثنا جرير عن الأعمش عن عبد الله بن عبد الله عن سعيد بن جبير عن العباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما
عن ابن عباس
رضي الله تعالى عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال تسمعون ويسمع منكم ويسمع ممن يسمع منكم وإسناده قوي والعبرة بعموم الخطاب لا بخصوص المخاطب فلا يزال من معالم العلم في هذه الأمة أن يأخذه الخالف عن السالف.
The author رحمه الله goes into the second issue, which is فتأخذه على مفيد ناصح. Now once you've memorized it, you take it to a مفيد ناصح. مفيد is a person who's going to benefit you. ناصح is a person who's a sincere advisor for you. فتفزع إلى شخص إلى شيخ. You run to a teacher or a sheikh. تتفهم عنه معاني, in which you understand from him the meanings that are in this book. يَتَّصِفُ بِهَذَيْنِ الْوَصْفَيْنِ. But this individual that you're taking the knowledge from has to be described with two descriptions. He has to have two descriptions and two wasf. وَأَوَّلُهُمَا, the first of those is الْإِفَادَةِ. He has to be مُفِيد, a person who, إِفَادَةِ here means هِيَ الْأَهْلِيَّةُ فِي الْعِلْمِ. He has authority in knowledge. فَيَكُونُ مِمَّنْ عُرِفَ بِطَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ. He's a person who's known to seek knowledge. He's known for seeking knowledge. وَتَلَقِّيهِ, and he's also known from taking knowledge from its people, أهل العلم. حَتَّى أَدْرَكَ, until he has reached. فَصَارَتْ لَهُ مَلَكَةٌ قَوِيَّةٌ فِيهِ. Until he has attained what? ملكة قوية. ما معنى ملكة قوية؟ ملكة means هيئة راسخة في النفس. He has become grounded. So the word إفادة means مفيد ناصح. And what does the word مفيد mean? مفيد means الأهلية في العلم. He's a person who has, he has أهلية in this. ما معنى أهلية؟ He has authority. He knows. He's the right person for the job. And how would he be a person who is for the job? How would he be a person who has ahliya, who has the rights? Two descriptions. The first one is, he is known to take knowledge from his people. فَيَكُونُ مِمَّنْ عُرِفَ بِطَلَبِ الْعِلْمِ وَتَلَقِّيهِ. He is known to take knowledge from its people, أهل العلم. And the second one is, فَصَارَتْ لَهُ مَلَكَةٌ قَوِيَّةٌ فِيهِ. He is grounded. Some people, they go to the mashayikh, they come back, they have nothing. They don't know their right hand from their left hand. Yeah? They don't know their right hand from their left hand in knowledge. But he sat in the circles of scholars. He sat in the halaqat. He sat from one book to the other book. But does he have malaka, qawiyya? No. So he hasn't got ahliya. It's when he's got these two both together. He's mufid, nasih, mufid. And where's the evidence for that? He says, wal aslu fi hadha ma akhrajahu Abu Dawood fi sunanihi. This is also what? The asl for this is. The asl for what? Al-ifada, to be mufid. The asl for that is what Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan. He said, حَدَّثَنَا زُهَيْرِ بْنُ حَرْبٍ وَعُثْمَانِ بْنَ أَبِي شَيْبَةَ قَالَا. Both of them said. Both of them are who? Zuhair ibn Harbin, who is Abu Khaythamata Zuhair ibn Harb. وعثمان ibn Abi Shayba, who said, both of them said, حَدَّثَنَا جَرِيرٌ عَنِ الْأَعْمَشِ عَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنَ عَبَّاسٍ No, عن عبد الله بن عبد الله عن سعيد بن جبير عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما عبد الله بن عباس said أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that the messenger said تسمعون you guys will hear ويسمع منكم and it will be heard from you guys ويسمع ممن سمع منكم and it will be heard from those who heard from you وإسناده قوي its chain is strong so this hadith shows what is known as taking knowledge from its people. And that is strong. It's like a chain. تسمعون you will hear from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions. ويسمع منكم and all you companions, it will be heard from you all. ويسمع ممن سمع منكم and those who heard from you all companions will be heard from as well. And then the author said after that, الشيخ صالح بن عبد الله بن حمد العصيمي said والعبرة بعموم الخطاب لا بخصوص المخاطب العبرة means what? The wisdom is in what? Is in the generalization of the speech and not those who the messenger is addressing. Meaning, you can't say this is only referring to the companions and that it's only them who would be heard from. Okay, and they are the only ones who are going to hear. No, it means everyone has to be like that. You guys will hear a knowledge, تسمعون. You guys are going to hear a knowledge. ويسمع منكم, and it will be heard from you. ويسمع ممن سمع منكم, and the one that heard from you will be heard from, and the one who heard from that one will be heard from, and it will go on. If your chain is disconnected, there's a problem now. This chain has to be from, everybody has to pass it on to the other, to the other, to the other. And it goes back to who? Nabiullah Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. There has to be tasalsul, which is that it's chain after chain, daraja, it's passed on. If a chain is broken from the middle, what's going to happen to that chain? It's going to break. And that's what happens when people come with strange opinions. Aqwal which are shad. The reason is because he didn't hear from the ulama. He didn't take it from them. And they didn't, this is where the problem is. And that's why when it came to the ayah, يَوْمَ نَدْعُوا كُلَّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ the day of judgment when everybody is going to be called with their imam. The Salaf of this Ummah, they used to say that the Imam of Ahlul Hadith is the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The Imam of Ahlul Hadith is who? The people of the Sunnah, who is their Imam? Why? Because their Imam, which they took knowledge from, who their chain goes back to, is Nabiullah Muhammad. There's no disconnection between them. Straight, pure from the Messenger alayhi salam, pure from him. Other people, what they want to do is, their ara and their opinions is what they want to sip into the concept. And they want to break the chain of the Muslims that they have. So, taking knowledge from who? Somebody who is ahliya fil ilm, who has the rights to speak about these issues. The one who doesn't have malaka qawiyya, or who hasn't taken knowledge from the ulama, as they say, faqidu shay'in la yu'tih. The one who doesn't have something can't give. What can you give? You're disconnected. And you're just going to disconnect my chain. فَلَا يَزَالُ مِن مَعَالِمِ الْعِلْمِ فِي هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ أَن يَأْخُذَهُ الْخَالِفُ عَنِ السَّالِفِ And he says, فَلَا يَزَالُ نَفْيُ نَفْيُ إِثْبَات Two negations, we said it becomes an affirmation. La is a negation, yazalu has a meaning of negation in it. So it becomes fayakunu. So the statement of the author is going to be what? Fala yazalu, we will turn it into fayakunu min ma'alim al-ilmi. Sah? Fayakunu min ma'alim al-ilmi. From the signs of knowledge in this ummah is an ya'khudahu al-khalifu anis-salifi. The Khalif is what? the latecomer. He takes it from what? As-Salifi. This is something, it's the milestone of this ummah. That they the latecomers are taken from the early generation. And that's how they're connected. That's the first description for the Mufid Nasih. Are you with me, brothers? We took what the word Mufid means, we're now going to take what the word Nasih means, which is the second description, right? Naam.
أما الوصف الثاني فهو النصيحة وتجمع معنيين اثنين أحدهما صلاحية الشيخ للاقتداء به والاقتداء بهديه ودله وسنته والآخر معرفته بطرائق التعليم بحيث يحسن تعليم المتعلم ويعرف ما يصلح له وما يضره وفق تربية العلمية التي ذكرها الشاطبي في الموافقات.
The author now goes into the second, which is فهو النصيحة, a person who is a sincere advisor. And the author then says وتجمع معنيين اثنين. It combines between, it has in it two meanings. تجمع, it combines معنيين, two meanings. The author, for him to bring اثنين is unnecessary because معنيين would have sufficed him. So اثنين is توكيد, it's an emphasis. What are the two meanings that are in the word nasiha? The first one is صَلَاحِيَّةُ الشَّيْخِ لِلِاخْتِدَاءِ بِهِ, that the shaykh is one who can be taken as a role model. وَلِاِهْتِدَاءِ بِهَدِّهِ وَدَلِّهِ وَسَمْتِهِ, that the shaykh is a person who the way he carries himself, his guidance, all of his هَدِّهِ وَدَلِّهِ وَسَمْتِهِ are all synonyms, they're close in meaning. Is a person who's his guidance, the way he carries himself and everything is what you can take from him. That particular shaykh, you can take all of that from him. صَلَاحِيَّةُ الشَّيْخَ لِلِاِخْتِدَاءِ, that the shaykh has صَلَاحِيَّة, he's perfect, he's correct for you to take a role model. He's not a fasiq, a person who's known for fisq and etc. He's a person who stays away from kaba'ir, major sins. If the person is doing saga'ir, minor sins, then this is something we believe that there's no ismah for nobody. There's nobody who's infallible. We're not waiting to study from angels. Ya Rasul Allah, akhta' and zallat and hafawat come. And some of the things that the author is going to mention later when it comes to dealing with your shaykh and your teacher, he mentions it at the ending. But it's that he's somebody who can be taken as a role model. وَالْآخَرُ, and the second is مَعْرِفَةُ بِطَرَائِقِ التَّعْلِيمِ, he knows the path of seeking knowledge. He's a person who knows this. بِحَيْثُ يُحْسِنُ تَعْلِيمَ الْمُتَعَلِّمِ, in which he can perfect the teaching of the one who he's teaching. He can tell him the right way to take. Actually, take this path, and this, do this, and this, and this, and this. A person needs somebody like that. وَيَعْرِفُ مَا يَصْلُحُ لَهُ وَمَا يَضُرُّ, he'll tell him what is good for you and what is harmful for you. وِفْقَ تَرْبِيَةِ الْعِلْمِيَّةِ الَّتِي ذَكَرَهَا الشَّاطِبِيُّ فِي الْمُوَافَقَاتِ, all of that is in accordance to the tarbiyah, the educational tarbiyah, in which Al-Imam al-Shatibi mentions in his Kitab al-Muwafaqat. So that the Shaykh is a person who knows the path of seeking knowledge. So we'll tell the student, listen, shall I be honest with you? Ha. Go and study in Egypt. Or go and do this. He says, I can go and memorize the Quran. Then I'm sincere advisor to you. Or do this. Ulama, before they would tell the people to seek knowledge, a person should go and take time out to memorize the Quran. Even if it's a small quantity and a small amount that you're memorizing, that you start memorizing the kalam of Allah. Because before, what did we speak about? بِحِفْظِ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ, are you going to memorize the speech of a human being and forsake the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you going to memorize lines of poetry when you don't know the Qur'an? The person needs to memorize the Quran. And so what the teacher does is that he tells the students paths to take, and gradual, how he gradually will bring, he'll reach the way he should do. He'll make him be able to become knowledge, that he's ready, he's reaped. ولذلك علي بن أبي طالب he said حدث الناس بما يعرفون أتريدون أن يكذب الله ورسوله أتريدون أن يكذب الله ورسوله علي بن أبي طالب he said tell the people that which they know, do you want them to disbelieve in Allah and His Messenger? And this concept is what? Knowing the people's brains and what they can take in. You don't want to overburden a person. Give them what is for their level. طُعْمُ الْكِبَارِ سُمُّ الصِّغَارِ. The food of the elders is poisonous for the youngsters. Al-Imam al-Shatibi, he mentions in his Kitab al-Muwafaqat, the author says, and this Shatibi, his name is Abu Ishaq Ibrahim ibn Musa ibn Muhammad al-Lakhmiyu. Al-Shatibi is from the ulama of Andalus. He was born in Gharnata when the year was 790. This is not the famous Qari Imam who specialized in Qiraat. That one, his name is called Abu Qasim al-Shatibi. Some say Abu Muhammad al-Shatibi, who wrote the book Hirzu al-Amani wa Wajhu al-Tahani. The book he wrote is called Hirzu al-Amani wa Wajhu al-Tahani, which is very well known as Manzumatu al-Shatibiyya. It's very well known as Manzumatu al-Shatibiyya. This is not the same one. This is another one. This is Abu Ishaq al-Shatibi, who wrote the Kitab al-Muwafaqat, and he also wrote the book Al-I'tisam. And he's very grounded and very solid in the science of Usulul Fiqh, Maqasid al-Shari'ah, etc. So when the person comes with all of those points that the author mentioned, all summarized in the line of poetry, فَمَا حَوَى الْغَايَاتُ فِي أَلْفِ سَنَةِ شَخْصٌ فَخُذْ مِنْ كُلِّ فَنٍ أَحْسَنَةِ بِحِفْظِ مَتْنٍ جَامِعٍ لِلْرَاجِحِ تَأْخُذُهُ عَلَى مُفِيدٍ نَاصِحِ. That person will become able to attain knowledge. He has taken the path for knowledge. We conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. We'll take 10 minutes break, and we will then carry on after as Kitab al-Waraqat bi-idhnillahi al-Kareem.